Welcome. In this video, we'll derive the formula that gives the value of an annuity after time t, given by this formula here, where a sub t is the value after t years, or the future value of the annuity, p sub n is the deposit at the end of each compounding period, which will always be the same, r is the annual interest rate, expressed as a decimal, n is the number of compounds per year, and t is time in years. An annuity is a sequence of equal payments made at equal time periods. For example, when saving for retirement, many people make payments into an IRA or an individual retirement account. The value of the annuity is the sum of all of the payments made into the account and all the interest earned over a time period. To derive this formula, we're first going to start with the future value of a one-time payment earning compounded interest given by this formula here, where a sub t is the amount after time t, p is the one-time deposit, r is the annual interest rate, n is the number of compounds per year, and t is time in years. And to simplify this a bit, we'll go ahead and assume the account will pay interest compounded annually, and therefore n is equal to 1. So if n is equal to 1, n times t would just be t, and r divided by n would just be equal to r. And now we can actually use a geometric series to represent the value of annuity that pays interest compounded annually for t years. So a sub 1 is equal to p, which would be the regular deposit into the account. Remember, this deposit is made at the end of each compounding period. And therefore, a sub 2, the value of the annuity after 2 years, would be equal to p times the quantity 1 plus r. This represents the deposit from the first year plus the interest plus p, the deposit for year 2. Therefore, a sub 3, the value after 3 years, is equal to p times the quantity 1 plus r to the second. This is the deposit from the first year plus 2 years of interest plus p times the quantity 1 plus r, which is a deposit from the second year, which is earned 1 year of interest, given by this product, plus p, again the deposit at the end of year 3. So you can see the pattern here, and therefore a sub t, the value of the annuity after t years, is equal to this represents the initial deposit from the first year plus all the interest plus p times the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t minus 2. This represents the deposit from the second year plus all the interest all the way down to plus p, which should be the deposit at the end of year t. So now let's take this formula onto the next slide. And now we'll perform some algebra on this equation. So for the first step, we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by the quantity 1 plus r. So on the left side, we have the quantity 1 plus r times a sub t, given by this product here. And on the right side, each of these products picks up another factor of 1 plus r. So for this first product, if we multiply by another factor of 1 plus r, we would have the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t. And then for the second term, we pick up another factor of 1 plus r, we'd have p times the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t minus 1, all the way to the end where this p picks up a factor of 1 plus r given by this product. So in this line, we have our new equation where both sides have been multiplied by the quantity 1 plus r. Then the next line here, then the next line, this line here, is actually the original formula that we developed on the other slide, or this formula here. And now to make this work, we're going to subtract these two equations. So we'll subtract the left sides of the equation and then subtract the right sides of the equation. So if we subtract the left sides, we have the quantity 1 plus r times a sub t minus a sub t given here. And then on the right side, a lot of these terms will simplify out. Notice here we have p times the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t minus 1. But then we're going to subtract the same term here. So this minus this would be 0. As we keep subtracting, again, most of the terms would simplify out. Notice here we have p times the quantity 1 plus r to the second minus p times the quantity 1 plus r to the second. These two terms would also simplify out. So one thing left would be this first term here, p times the quantity 1 plus r to the t, and then minus this p here. So now we'll take this equation here and solve for a sub t. To do this, we'll first distribute to eliminate the parentheses here. So we would have a sub t plus a sub t r minus a sub t. And on the right side, let's go ahead and factor out the common factor of p. So we'll have p, and then we'll have the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t minus 1. And now looking at the left side, notice how we have a sub t minus a sub t, so that's 0. So we just have a sub t r. And then on the right side, let's go ahead and change these outer parentheses to braces or brackets. So we'll have p, and then in brackets, the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of t minus 1. And now for the last step, we'll divide both sides by r. This simplifies to 1. So we have a sub t equals p times the quantity 1 plus r to the power of t minus 1 divided by r. And this is the formula that we can use to determine the value of annuity if we have annual payments earning interest compounded annually. Remember, to simplify this work, we replaced n times t with t and r divided by n with r since we let n equal 1. If n wasn't equal 1, we could perform the opposite substitution, replacing t with n times t and replacing r with r divided by n. And therefore, we just derived the value of annuity formula given here using a simpler case to get the same result. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found this explanation helpful.